Hi, this is Wayne Zell, host of Blueprint for Wealth and founder and managing member of Zell Law in Reston, Virginia. Today's video blog is an excerpt from my new book, Your Multi-Million Dollar Exit, The Entrepreneur's Business Succession Planner, due out in early 2023. So I hope you enjoy this excerpt and stay tuned for the book. Today, we're going to talk about retention bonuses, a bonus that's given to an employee for staying on with a company after it's sold. Many deals involve retention bonuses. They're offered to key employees who are critical to the future success of the business. They become even more important if the seller is subject to an earnout, meaning a payout, based on the performance of the company after the closing of the sale. So keeping your key employees involved after the closing is really important. So you want to give them an incentive to do so. If a key employee leaves during the earnout period, the period that the earnout is measured, this performance bonus for the whole company, for the seller, they typically will forfeit all or a portion of the retention bonus as well. But if they leave during the earnout period and haven't been promised a retention bonus, there's nothing for them to lose in leaving the company, unless, of course, they have equity in the new company. The timing of a retention bonus is really, really important. If you wait just right before the closing to give a retention bonus to an employee, it may appear that you must give them a retention bonus in order for the company to succeed after the closing. If, on the other hand, you enter into the agreement with an employee for a retention bonus, and the employees really don't know that you've entered into a transaction to sell the company, or it hasn't been defined clearly, then you're showing your appreciation for their loyalty and hard work. And they may take a very different view and appreciate the gesture. In any case, the retention bonus agreement should clearly state that no bonus is payable to a key employee unless and until you actually close the sale of your company. Retention bonuses sometimes are paid by the buyer, and sometimes they're paid by the seller, and sometimes the parties agree to split the retention bonus. If you're a seller, of course, you want the buyer to pay it. But the retention bonuses might be paid based on the level, on the period of time that the employee remains employed with the acquiring business. So buyer comes in, buys your business. You need this key employee to stay involved so you can get the rest of your purchase price that you negotiated in the transaction in the form of an earnout. That key employee needs to stay for some period of time. Sometimes it might be 12 months. Sometimes it might be 24 months. And I've seen them as long as 36 months. If the employee leaves voluntarily or dies or becomes disabled during that period over which the retention bonus is payable, they will receive only the portion of the retention bonus that's earned before termination of employment, and they give up the rest. If they're terminated without cause, or they leave with good reason, the entire retention bonus might be accelerated, might be paid all at once. And if they're terminated with cause, meaning that they've engaged in some kind of bad act, they usually have to forfeit the bonus. These terms are always defined in the retention bonus agreement or in an employment agreement if they have an employment agreement with the new employer. But the goal is to make sure that the key employees remain with the company if you have any portion of your purchase price that's payable after the closing in the form of an earnout or a contingent purchase price. The employee, the key employee, wants to include provisions in the retention bonus agreement that require payment of the full bonus if the employee is terminated without cause, or they die or become disabled, or if they leave with good reason, meaning the employer did something bad to cause them to leave voluntarily. Again, these terms are usually defined in the retention bonus agreement or in the employment agreement for the key employee.